This is a lesson for Java newbies who have not yet built a Hello World program. So traditionally, the first program that people write in a new language is Hello World, just to display the words Hello World. So I'm going to step through that and show you how that's done with NetBeans. And for Eclipse people, there'll be an equivalent video showing how to do it in Eclipse. Okay, so let's create a new project. And it's going to be a Java application. And we'll call it Hello World App. We're going to have a main class, and I'll talk a little bit more about that in a minute. But we're not going to use the package name. So it's just going to say Hello World App, just like that. Clicking Finish. And now I have this, which actually doesn't do anything at this point. I'm going to stick in a little bit of code here, and then we'll start going step by step through this. So actually, I think what I'll do first is I want to explain there are three basic components that the Hello World application is going to have. We have the source code comments. So when you see this slash followed by an asterisk, and then you can have as many lines as you want, and then have an asterisk followed by a slash, that closes off comments. And comments are basically things that you write in the code that is not seen by the compiler. So the computer doesn't read this stuff. This is set aside. When the computer sees the slash and the asterisk, and then finished off with the asterisk and the slash, the computer knows, oh, I'm going to ignore this stuff. This is things, little notes that are written for as reminders for programmers when they will go back and look at their own code, or as information for other programmers who need to make changes to their code at some point. So, you know, you'll see some information like this, who's the author, parameters, and you know, details that we'll talk about some more another time. But let me just comment in here. So I'm just going to make a note saying what this application is about. So the Hello World app class implements an application that simply prints Hello World to standard output. And if you want to read some more about this, I'm going to stick a link. I'm getting a lot of this off of the Java tutorials from Oracle. So I'll send you a link. I'll have a link to this page post it, but so that this is the source code application. The source code comments. Okay, so that's things that are added to be of use to programmers. Okay, let's see. There are three different kinds of comments that you can do. So you see, we talked about the slash with an asterisk and then text in there. It says ignore all that. Also notice there's this one, the slash with two asterisks. That's these are known as documentation comments. Okay, so the compiler ignores all comments, but you can actually use the documentation comments to automatically generate documentation. And there's a special JavaDoc tool that you can use to do that. Again, we can talk about that another time. And then there's this //, which is used for, basically it tells the compiler, ignore everything from here to the end of the line, okay? So the text comments and the documentation comments are for multi-line comments. We just have a really short for one line. You can stick it in here. So let's do, I'm going to write the code piece now. Let me explain the class definition first. So this bit right here, it says public class Hello World app. This indicates a class, the beginning of a class definition, okay? So the class definition block is basically, it starts with this header here. This is public class Hello World app. Hello World app is the name of our class. And it extends from this starting brace. And notice when I click here, this ending brace immediately gets highlighted. So this whole block is our class definition, and it tells us what kind of things that this class can do. If there's information stored by the class, then we'll have fields for storing class information and so on. But that's the basics of that. And then inside the class are the method definitions. And the method definitions basically define for the program what a particular class can do, okay? The main method is the class that's run when we say run project in here, okay? Or run file. So I'm going to write down. And notice also there are opening and closing braces for the method. So the whole method is inside the class. Okay, the class starts here and stops here, and there can be any number of methods inside the class. But the method has a similar kind of format. So it's like Russian nesting dolls, kind of. So the entire method opens and closes inside the class. Okay. So inside the method, in the method definition, we can write down the statements that are to be executed when we run the method. Okay. And like I said, main gets run automatically whenever we do like a run file or whatever. Okay, so notice this says to do code application logic here. So I'm gonna add the logic right now for the application in this main method here. So I'm gonna say system.out.println Hello world, and we can stick one of these little one-line comment things in here. So I did it again, //, And now I can just say display the, oops, display the string. Okay. And now let's just run. If I say run file, it runs the file. And look at this right down here. It says hello world. So, let me just make sure. Let me just show you this one last picture. So basically, the way these are constructed is, and we have this access modifier public. We'll talk about that later. You don't necessarily have to have that up in there. You'll see examples without it. So you can have class followed by the name of the class. So this is the general form, okay, of this application. You have the class name, then we have the opening brace and the closing brace, right? So everything, all the methods, all the, if we're going to have fields later to store information, everything is going to be in between this top brace here and this bottom brace here. Okay, so that's why the indentation helps, because then you can see your indenting when you format your code. You can see that this entire method here is inside the class. So this is our main method, public static void main. Arguments, we're actually not using any arguments right now to the main method, so I don't have to worry about that. And then the statements go inside. Okay, so that's our Hello World app. And there's still more to be seen about this, and I encourage you, like I said, to go look at other sites and go more deeply into this, but I want to give you a rough sketch of the Hello World app so that we can move on and get started with the graphics stuff.